sinks in darkness. Aching cold sets into an unfamiliar body. A distant howling surrounds you, louder with each passing second. Insistent and invisible hands slap and tear at the membrane that protects you. Your first emotion is an involuntary and formless panic. You feel you have forgotten something, something important. As if it once meant the world to you, but the details slip away as you grasp at them. You force your eyes open. A white-pink fleshy cocoon surrounds you. Even as you look, a minor rent in its side tears open, and the howling wind forces its way inside. The cocoon rips away, gone before you can grab it, spinning you into a dizzying tunnel. You are falling, the world many kilometers beneath you. You catch a glimpse of a curved horizon, and also the ground beneath you that is approaching deceptively quickly. Above you, a small moon is slowly collapsing in upon itself, a corona of acid green and black energy playing around its edges. The wind buffets you and burns your eyes, but you don't need to see the details of the faraway ground to know you're in serious trouble. You won't survive a fall from this stratospheric height. A part of your frantic mind battles that technically you probably fell from a thermospheric height. You struggle to stay focused as the ground rushes toward you. Instinctively, you spread your arms and legs, and they respond sluggishly. You stop tumbling head over heels. Though you are still spinning laterally, that motion has calmed as well, and you have space to assess your situation, and perhaps to understand the predicament and the body in which you find yourself. Below you, you see a large landmass. A massive ocean dominates the rest of the visible globe, dotted here and there with island chains. Small moons, unusual structures, and strange machines rush past you in glittering profusion as you plummet toward the ground. Now you see that this appears to be a huge megacontinent, the only land of any size, on this side of the world at least. Great inland seas and lakes dot the land, and curiously, regular mountain ranges march up and down and across. You are falling toward what looks to be a great bay, a sprawling city perched on its shore just to the north. Further to the north and east, you see a broad plain scattered with curious structures, visible even from this height. The northeastern portion of this land looks to be a desert, a strange blue dot like an eye in its exact center. It seems to hold a city in its watery grasp. To its west is a ring of huge mountains surmounted by enormous carved peaks spewing magma into a central catch basin. What concerns you most right now is the bay below you. It's coming at you quickly. You don't seem to have any other option. You close your eyes to the world below you. Ignore the rushing of the wind past you and concentrate. You remember that you were in the hallways of a place that wove itself through your blood, through your thoughts. The memories project themselves in your mind, a story told to you as if they happened to someone else. Yet it was your body that walked those halls, your lungs that breathed that air. You were running because something was hunting you, a nightmare far more powerful than you. Were you bound? Examining your stolen memory, you know that you were. What could have stood against you? Who wielded instruments of flame and time itself? The name is on the tip of your tongue. You were... Who? Who were you? If you somehow managed to sidestep everything you know about anatomy, physics, and death, and you were surprised to realize that you do know something about them, and you survive this fall, you suspect that you might be able to reawaken a dormant strength you sense inside you. But who could possibly survive a fall from this height? You remember reaching an escape tube, and you remember being struck by a tendril of force, and then the fall. You open your eyes in time to see a riot of color around you, your descent barely slowed, and then agony flares throughout your body as a crunching impact destroys you. The last thing you hear is a rapidly cycling line of energy, and then darkness.